On Newsstream, we're shining a spotlight on social media. Many of us spend a lot of time on sites like Facebook or Twitter. They help keep us connected to friends and family, or perhaps introduce us to people who share our interests. But social media has also created new problems in our lives. And one of those is digital privacy. A company in the Netherlands is selling these coffee cups to highlight exactly that point. Now, you might recognize the children's faces on these mugs. They might even be your children. That's because these images have been taken from the photo sharing site Flickr. Kristie Lu Stout spoke to co-creator Dimitri Tokmetsis, who says it's completely legal.
Well, I did this project with designer Yuri Veerman, and we wanted to show that even if you share your personal information online, you still have a right to privacy. And that sounds a little bit strange coming from us. And our webshop is outrageous. It really is. But basically, we are doing something that many social companies like Facebook and Google are doing as well. They use your information to learn about your habits and your personality, and they sell these insights to advertisers, because these companies are, at their core, advertising companies, and not only social platforms or in any way your friend. So the only thing we have done is to make this visible in a very shocking way, I think, and we are not doing anything illegal. Nevertheless, it feels wrong for most people, and they are upset about it.
And where did you find the photos online?
We found them on Flickr. People put them on the photo website Flickr, and they can choose between different kinds of licenses, like they can keep the copyright themselves, or they can use a commercial Creative Commons license. And these people have used a Creative Commons license, which that gives us permission to use it. And they've used a license that allows for commercial reuse. So we can use these photos commercially.
What you're doing is completely legal, but it just feels a little bit eyebrow-raising. So what kind of reaction have you been getting to your project?
Well, we were really surprised about it. We would think that people would be very angry, especially the parents. And some parents asked us to remove the photos, which we actually did right away. But most of them were pretty sympathetic, because they understood that they put the photos there themselves, that they didn't pay attention to the license they used. And they sympathized with the message we wanted to give. That is, that you have to be careful about what you post online.
Do you feel that too many parents are sharing just too much information and data about their babies and children online?
Definitely, definitely. I've got two small children myself, and it's really hard to keep control of those kinds of pictures and photos. And the problem is, you also have family that are posting a lot of photos on, about children or one of the problems is that children haven't consented to that. So it's nice to post all kinds of photos now, but do they actually like it when they are 18 years old or when they are adults? Then the photos are still there. So basically, the children don't have a choice in this matter.
You know, we now live in a world where someone can have a digital footprint the moment he or she is born without his or her consent. I mean, what kind of challenge does that pose?
A big challenge, because you don't know what happens to your information. Like I said, Facebook does basically the same. If you post something on Facebook, you agree to the terms and services of Facebook, and they can reuse your data, your photos or everything you write. They can reuse that in any way they want, and they can sell that data. And the problem is, you don't see what they are doing. If you browse to a normal website, often about 20 or 30 advertising companies are watching you doing that. We don't know what happens to that data, and there is no easy way to visualize that or to make people understand what happens, because the technology is really complicated. It's really difficult to see what happens under the hood of that technology.
So for parents out there who've been listening in on our conversation, what should we do? Should we just stop social sharing photos and information about our kids, or do we just need to be smarter about it?
Don't stop. No, I like the internet. Everybody likes the internet. But be careful with what you post. And if you post something of your children, remember that other people can use it as well. Plus, if you post something of other people's children, ask their permission first.